Welcome to SST College of Arts and Commerce. Myself, Assistant Professor Kashish Hodchandani, welcomes you in SST Edupedia. So today we are going to discuss channels of communication from the subject Business Communication. It is taken from Unit 1, Theory of Communication, SEM 1. Today we are going to see types of communication channels. So each and every firm or organization has a formal setup. It has an organizational pattern. To carry out its activities very perfectly, it employs people who work at different levels with certain duties, authorities, and powers assigned to them. As per the needs of the organization and as per the ability and qualification of the employees, they are appointed at suitable positions. They are placed, and this placement and different levels or ladders which people work within an organization is called as line of authority or hierarchy. So the power to take the decisions lies with the board of directors, while the execution of the policies is entrusted to the managing director. So before I proceed further, I would like to explain you the channels of communication which you can see on the screen. So there are two channels of communication, formal and informal. Formal channel is again bifurcated into vertical, horizontal and diagonal. Vertical communication is again categorized into downward communication and upward communication. Informal channel of communication consists of grapevine. What is vertical communication? Vertical communication takes place between different levels of organization. Communication between principal and student, or communication between student and principal, is the best example. So vertical communication is again bifurcated into downward communication and upward communication. Downward communication is the communication from superior to subordinate, that is from principal to the student. It is useful for giving specific job instructions, rules, regulations and appraising subordinates. Upward communication is the communication which takes place from subordinate to superior, that is from student to principal. It is useful for giving response to orders, instructions and suggesting ideas. As you all can see on my screen, vertical communication in the organization takes place from managing director to general manager, then assistant general manager, divisional or departmental heads, supervisors and employees. So two types of vertical communication are there, upward and downward. Upward communication is from employees or workers to the managing director, and downward communication is from managing director to employees. Next is horizontal communication. Horizontal communication is the communication where information flows among the similar or same level status of people in an organizational structure. For example, purchase manager will communicate with production manager, or production manager will communicate with sales manager. Production manager can also do communication with quality control manager. Other example, a student communicating with student, a coordinator communicating with coordinator, a teacher is coordinating with another teacher. So communication which takes place with the same level of people, ek student dusre student se baat kar raha hai, ek teacher dusre student se teacher se baat kar rahi hai, isse bolte hain horizontal communication, communicating with the same status or same level of people. Next we have diagonal communication. Diagonal communication is a blend of horizontal as well as vertical communication. So diagonal communication takes place at different levels in the hierarchy. It occurs both ways, that is from the upper, lower, to lower and vice versa. The path is mixture of vertical and horizontal movement. So diagonal communication, anyone can contact, anyone in the hierarchy can pass on the message to each other, can communicate with each other. Example, Supervisor can directly contact with manager, or divisional head can directly contact with the managing director, or general manager can directly contact with the workers of any department. It is not of any specific department, but if there is any emergency or any urgency is there, so anyone from the hierarchy can contact with each other. So now is informal channel. Informal channel refers to the interchange of information unofficially. So the best example is when we talk to our colleagues, when we talk to our friends, that is called as informal communication. In this, there is no need to maintain any hierarchy, no need to maintain the ladder. So this communication is based on the informal relations like friendship, the same place of birth, the membership of the same club, etc. The exchange of informal messages usually takes place on the certain occasions like parties, business meetings, social occasions, etc. So informal communication जो हम day to day में अपने friends से, अपने colleagues से बात करते हैं, that is called as informal communication. In informal communication we have grapevine. Grapevine is an informal channel of communication which is unofficial and unorganized. Grapevine is active when a group of people of similar status and interest are together outside the organization, example in the canteen or in the corridor. Employees see it as a source of information and the management sees it as a source of feedback. So grapevine, whenever we sit outside the organization in canteen, or we sit for refreshment, or we meet in the corridor, we usually talk, right? That is called as informal communication. So we have types of grapevine. The first one is chain, second one is random, third one is wheel. So in chain grapevine we have the most common pattern in which information passes through a series of people linked together in an organization. It means that it passes from one person to another and to the next. A passes information to B, B passes it to C, and C passes it to D. So one person is passing it to the another single person. It goes like the chain. The next is random grapevine. The random pattern spreads in haphazard manner between people who know and who do not know the news. So random grapevine, the meaning is randomly it passes to each and everyone in the organization. Not related to any specific department, it can pass to each and every department randomly. Next is wheel grapevine. In a wheel grapevine, one person transmits the message to different people or groups of the people. He is at the center of the wheel. So one person is responsible, one person passes the message to different people or to the different groups, and accordingly the communication is taken place. What is the use of grapevine in organization? It acts as a source of feedback. It keeps the organizations aware of the potential problems, keeping employees well informed about the changes in procedures, work methods or personnel, helps to build trust and promote cooperation, concentrate on identifying and stopping wrong information from spreading, try to identify the influential leaders of grapevine and try to feed them with current factual information. So grapevine acts as a very good source of feedback to the organization. Whatever problems are there, we share with our friends. We can't share with our superiors or supervisor, but yes, we share with our friends. And what happens because of this, the problems of our colleagues, the problems of our friends, directly or indirectly reaches to the organization, to the higher level of management, right? And it also helps to build and promote cooperation. So we are very comfortable to coordinate, we are very comfortable to communicate with our friends rather than with our superiors. So informal channel of communication gives us a platform wherein if we are very scared to talk with our supervisors or with our managers or with the higher positional manager, we can easily and directly talk with our friends through informal channel of communication. We can share our problem. It is not compulsory that we should always talk with our supervisors or with our head. Our problem can also be sorted out with our friends, with our colleagues or with the same post of person. Because it's like that ki it's better to share with friends and with our colleagues, because sometimes we get the solution from them also. So informal channel of communication is very important in the organization as it has many advantages. So today we have studied about different channels of communication, formal and informal. The first one is vertical. Again, it consists of downward communication and upward communication. Downward communication is the communication which takes place from the higher level manager to the lower level manager. And upward communication is the communication which takes place from the lower level manager to the higher post manager. And horizontal communication is the communication which takes place between the same post. Or I gave you the example, a teacher is communicating with teacher, a sales manager is communicating with the sales manager, and so on. Next, we have seen the diagonal communication. As you can also see in the diagram, the vice president of marketing is communicating with the manager of the finance, and the vice president of operation is communicating with the manager of sales. Diagonal communication takes place at different levels in the hierarchy, and also it is a blend, it is a mixture of vertical and horizontal movement. I hope it is clear to everyone. Thank you.